It's just annoying. The moment I had somewhat fixed up the COMPAQ Portable Plus, this ancient MFM hard drive played dead on me. The question is, can I revive this bad hard drive? I love old computers. I love to collect them. I love to fix them. I'm the vintage collector and these are my stories. So the second time in a row I have to open up the case of this machine. And it won't just stop there. For these old machines, removing drives typically requires to tear down almost everything.
It seems like nobody was thinking about maintainability back then.
Anyways, I'll have to remove all add-in cards, the video controller, the hard drive controller and also the floppy disk controller. The drive cage is secured from both sides, so also the backside lid must be removed in order to also access the backside mounting screws. Taking the drive cage out was a bit fiddly as it got stuck repeatedly. Once removed, unfastening the screws allows removal of the drive itself from the cage. I think I can ignore the loss of warranty warning, can I?
Yeah.
Ah, come on! Not seriously. Finally, the plain old hard drive lies in front of me. Now, to be honest, it's the first time I touch a hard drive. I have barely any knowledge and I'm just acting on a friend's recommendations here. So I'll be starting by carefully removing the PCB. Then I see the magnet coil, which has this locking mechanism. As a first action, I try to clean that a bit. There's a small head attached to the coil which has developed some patina. Removing that with a Q-tip and some alcohol already made a big difference as it was very sticky and felt some big resistance before. After cleaning it, the coil could easily be pushed out from the locking position. I was then also adding a drip of oil and let it stay for a night. The day after, I was reassembling everything again and connecting the hard drive on the fly.
You really believe this should be working now?
I don't know. I'll power it up. Ha! Ha 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 ha! Ha! It spins up. It's unbelievable. It spins up.
I never had any doubts.
Wait a second. You were the one saying... Ah, never mind. It's really unbelievable, so it was just stuck on a spindle. Can it be as simple as that? I had then run Norton Disk Doctor on it, which, as you can see, had some sectors marked defective. But I know from a previous run that these defects were already existing before. Maybe I should perform a low-level format, just in case, and hope it would clear out those defective sectors. I'll be using SpinRite to do this test. It will perform some integrity checks first, which really takes some time to complete. Although this is time-consuming, SpinRite will perform an initial assessment of the drive characteristics before it starts a test series. The test series then covers different aspects, being it here the sector interleave, or, like here, an intense benchmark assessment.
But this puts quite some stress onto this old plater.
Yeah, but on the other hand, if the drive were really dead, it would probably explode during those thorough tests. So in my opinion, doing some stress tests can only be helpful in determining if the drive is still any good. And eventually we end up on the extended surface test, quite similar to Norton Disk Doctor before. After a while I realized I had SpinRite running in level 4, which only tests. But actually, I would like it to try recovering bad sectors wherever possible. At this stage, it can be actually switched into level 5 mode on the fly. I'm really curious if it can recover those bad sectors. Chances may be good, since the testing is a lot more sophisticated than good old check disk or even NDD ever were. a look and how it does. At least this first bad sector, after working on it for several minutes, was recovered again. And even the second one went away. The summary screen eventually reveals how it recovered 3 sectors and then eventually 6. And we're not even halfway through yet. And this concludes part 2 of my look into the COMPAQ Portable Plus restoration. All I wanted was to play around with Microsoft Xenix, but then that hard drive played dead on me. But as it seems, and I do hope it stays like that, all it took was a drip of oil, as otherwise I'd have to retrofit an XDID adapter with a compact flash. The extensive tests using SpinRite did not only seem to confirm the hard drive was working or working again, but it could even recover the bad blocks that I had seen already on an earlier occasion. Hopefully, I'm all set now for my look into Xenix. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my story. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.
Next on the Vintage Collector. So I'm creating a bunch of floppies for Xenix 86. It's booting up as it seems. Uh-oh, read errors from the floppy disk.
If you check out this channel's community tab, you'll find some polls on potential upcoming videos. You're very welcome to upvote on upcoming topics or drop in new ones you'd like me to chase down.